does and how it does. So DRM is a tool for building and managing our enterprise dimensions, enterprise metadata. So any company will have different dimensions in SBS. You people might be aware we have accounts, time period, location, company code, we have scenarios. We could have cost centers and different dimensions which we might have in our Hyperion applications. So all these companies' metadata can be managed in DRM, and it acts as a central repository where we can have all our company metadata. And this system will be feeding to our downstream Hyperion applications or OVI or any other analytical applications which we might be using in the company. So this is basically to build and manage our enterprise dimensions metadata. And then it streamlines the process of updating dimensional data. So it's, as I said, it acts as a central repository. We have all our metadata in one place. So we have a uniformity of dimensions across various downstream applications. Third point, it says aligns critical dimensions across dimensions. So for example, we have account dimensions. So for example, we have five different SBS cubes, one HFM application, two, three planning applications. And then we have account dimensions present in all these downstream systems. So we have one DRM application where we have account dimensions, and we'll be maintaining one account version over there. And that account version will be feeding to all the downstream systems so that we have alignment of our dimensions across different downstream systems. And then the fourth option, as I said, it publishes dimensions to downstream systems. And it simplifies compliance with regulatory standards. So we have different SOX compliance and all, and we have now DRG concepts in DRM. So that also can be implemented in DRM. This is technology independent. It can act as a standalone. It can be integrated with different systems, GL system. It can be integrated. It can be integrated with EPMA, or it can be the export from DRM can be fed into relational schema, and that can be used as a source to different downstream applications. So this is basic about DRM, what it does. And then if we talk about enterprise dimensions, so as you all have worked on different Hyperion tools, so you might be knowing about what dimensions are. So as it is mentioned over here, we could have different chart of accounts supporting multiple accounting standards, GAAP, IFRS, and different accounting standards. So if we have different accounts which comes from the GL system, the accounting team, then we could have cost centers, we could have locations, business units, or any other dimension, product, customers. We could have different dimensions in an enterprise, and that all these dimensions can be managed in DRM as a central repository, and this system can feed to different downstream applications. So here is an example of a DRM system. So at the bottom, you see Oracle Hyperion Data Relationship Management. So this is the standard user interface for all dimension maintenance. Okay, and this could have cost center, GL accounts, organization, entity, time, product, customers, or any other dimensions which any enterprise might have. And this system can feed to our GL system, planning system, reporting, analytics, data warehouse, SBS, or any other downstream systems. As I said, the feed from DRM can be pushed to our relational schema. We can create our own data model, and this feed from DRM can be fed to relational schema, and that schema model can be used for any downstream applications. Okay. Any questions so far? I don't want to move any further. If anybody has question on what DRM does and how it does. Okay. Okay, we'll move to next slide to see about the architecture of DRM. So as you can see, we have four different things which are available in DRM. One is the web client. This is the primary user interface where we'll be managing our metadata. So end user will be logging through Firefox or IE, and it acts as a user interface for end users. They will be updating their managing their metadata from this tool. Then we have DRM web server. So this acts, this takes the request whatever user sends in, and then pass it on to the application server. And then this application server it actually processes the user request and manages metadata for each application. And this acts as a communicator between database. So whenever a user sends in a request to manage any metadata, read, write, or update, so it goes to the web server. And from there, it goes to application server, and this actually processes the request. So for this application server, we need .NET Framework 4.5 for 11.1.2.4. And this communicates between database and the front-end client. And at the back-end, as you see, we have a relational database. So this actually stores all our metadata which are present in DRM. So the supported database as of now are Oracle and SQL Server 2005. So this is a basic architecture about DRM. And as we see, this application server, which is the which actually processes the user request and manages metadata for each application, it acts as a it communicates with database and the user, which is processing the request from hitting the request from the web client. So here's a detailed view of what all components are present in application server. So this we are not going to dive in detail as of now, but I'll give you a brief about the different components. So as you can see, we have different components in application server. We have configuration file, which is having all the details about your application which you have created in DRM. Then we have batch client. So this is basically used to automate any process which we might be doing manually in DRM. For example, we have to import metadata, we have to export, and there are some other options available in DRM which can be done manually. So instead of doing it manually, we can do it through automated way, which can be done through your batch client. DRM console, again, it's a user interface. DRM console is the place from where we'll be creating application and all, okay? And internally, it has different engines. It has process manager, API address. So I'm going to skip this because I want to show mainly in the tool itself how things work. Okay. And this is the implementation process for any DRM application. We create an application in DRM first. And then we create our versions. We'll talk about versions, what versions are, what hierarchies are, nodes are. We create our versions, hierarchies, and nodes. Then we define different properties. So as you might be aware, in SBS or planning or HFM, we have different properties for each of the member. For example, in SBS, I have this Excel sheet with me, which is I export from SBS. So for example, this is for time period. So as you see, we have different properties, parent, child, alias is a property, consolidation, data storage, we have generation, label, time balance, skip property. These are basically used for account dimensions. Then we have variance reporting, two-pass calculation, formulas for any account dimension. We could have any description or comment or different properties. We could have UDAs in SBS. We could have attribute dimensions. So all these things can be managed in DRM as a central repository. Okay, so we create different properties in DRM, which might be of our use. If we are using SBS, just showed you, we could have different properties required for SBS. For HFM, we could require any different properties. For any other downstream application, the property could be different. So those all properties can be created. Okay, then we have we can query the data and compare the data. So for example, we have this month of account version, and we have been given request to update account dimension. And next month we have changes. So we can do a comparison of the two versions and get to know what all changes have been done from the previous month. So those things also can be done in DRM. Then we can update the data with action scripts. So for example, we get a request to add a new cost center to our entity dimension. So those things, instead of doing it manually into the tool, we can do it through action script. We'll see all these things once we dive into the tool. Blend version, I'm going to skip as of now. We'll see in the tool itself. Then we can create properties with formulas and validate data. So as we know, there are different validations which are set in SBase or in any other downstream systems. For example, SBase we have different validations, right, when we create an application. So all those validations can be created in DRM. So that in DRM only it will check for all the any validation failure which might be there, which might be occurring for any for the downstream systems. So all those validations can also be created. Node types, again, security and all can also be set in DRM. For example, we have account dimension hierarchy, okay, and we have different account groups, balance sheet, income statement, asset, liabilities, and we want certain group of users to have access only on the balance sheet accounts, so we can give that as well. So security is also very intact in DRM. We can export the data. Data here means metadata in DRM. So we can export metadata from DRM and push it to our downstream systems. Then, as I said, we have a security in place in DRM, which also can be implemented. So for example, we have different dimensions as versions in DRM, and we want a certain group of users to have access only to customer dimension. So that also can be set in DRM. So when that user logs in, he'll not be able to see other dimensions. Instead, he'll be able to see only customer dimension or whatever dimension he needs an access to. And then we have a good audit trial option in DRM. And then we have now in 1.2, I think 1.2.3 onwards, we have DRG in place where we can have our DRG in place. We have workflow models in DRM itself. So this is a basic introduction about the tool, how it works and all. So any questions so far? Or else then we'll move into directly into the tool and see.
Hello, Shai.
Yep.
This is Monty here. Systems, like we have a lot of existing systems, like we have HR, we have PSS, we have ICM, information management, RTP, all these things. Then we want to maintain a golden data repository for that, mm-hmm. which will throw based on the raw and blessed data. Then we have to throw it in the golden standard template, right? Then then we can, as you told that, on the security perspective, we can get access on the platform, right?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And then we can throw an output, it may be the final, like user interface, maybe SSDC, or it may be some wiki conflict kind of thing. So how mm-hmm. are the DBMS will help us to design the data and give a better output to our customer?
See, DRM acts as a single source of truth for metadata for any enterprise. Okay, so all your company metadata will be present in DRM. And then, as I said, the export could be done directly to the downstream applications through EPM and all, or it could be done to a relational database model, which you might have created. All the metadata can be pushed to the model, data model, and then from there, any downstream application can pick it up from there.
So, as I told that, is it compatible or is it integratable with SFDC?
With?
Revenant.
I could not hear you.
With Salesforce. Am I clear now?
Yes, yes. You are asking the integration with Salesforce.
Right, yeah.
Direct integration, I have not tried, but as I said, we can push all these metadata from DRM to any data model which you might have created, and from there, if Salesforce can pick, it can pick it up from there.
Okay. Thank you.
Welcome. Any other questions on these things? Okay, so we'll, any questions?
Is it possible to recap? I joined a bit late.
Mm-hmm. I think you'll have to check with Kapil. He might be recording the session, so you might get a recording of this.
Okay, sure.
No, I will share whatever you missed. I will share with you. Suresh, is it Suresh or Sri?
Yeah.
Okay.
No, it's Sri. Yeah.
Sri. Okay, Sri. Okay.
Thanks, Kapil. Yeah.
Okay, so we'll go directly to the tool and see what all different components are there. So as we saw over here in the application server, we have a DRM console, and this DRM console is used to set up and configure and monitor your DRM applications. So I'm going to close this out so that we can see it from scratch. So I have installed DRM on my local machine. So here is the configuration console. Here is your migration utility and web client, which we were seeing over here. So web client is the browser through which end user will access DRM. Migration utility is basically used to migrate any DRM application with all its metadata and properties from one server to another server, or to the same server itself to a different application. Configuration console, it's basically used to set up and configure and monitor your DRM applications, which you might have created. So I'm going to open this console first. So as you see in the folder, Oracle Middleware EPM System 11R1 Products DRM and Client, you have different clients available. Batch client, this is for automation. Migration client, this is for migrating a DRM application from one server to another. And batch web client is basically used for end user to log into DRM through a browser. Okay. This configuration console can be opened from if you have the access to the server path. From there also you can access this. You can go to server path, products DRM server, go to bin, and in the bin folder you will see a DRM server console. So from there also you can access this. So this is the look and feel of DRM console. So as you see, I have created two different applications in my DRM. So every DRM application has to have its own repository. Okay, so for example, this application DRM1 is using DRM underscore DB database, and this DRM2 application which I have created, this is using DRM underscore DB1. So this is the repository where all your DRM related tables are created in these repositories. So we'll see how to create an application in subsequent sessions once we start our classes. But as of now, this is the repository schema where all the app metadata and different properties of DRM2 application will sit. Okay. Then we have different options to integrate. SMTP server is also there if you want to trigger mails and all. That also is there in this. We can configure it with our EPM systems. Through shared services, we can integrate this one as well. So we'll see a detail about these things in our subsequent session. But as of now, I just wanted to show you one thing. Once we create a DRM application using some repository, so in the repository, it creates 122 different tables at the backend. And those tables are being used to have all the metadata and different properties which you create through the user interface. So for example, I don't have PLSQL installed in my machine, so if I just show you all different tables which have been created, so you see total 122 different tables have been created in this schema where your DRM application will sit. Okay, and all For example, all the information, whether of versions, your user IDs and all, your different options which we have available in DRM, all those things will sit into these 122 different tables. Okay. So for example, if I show you one table called RM underscore user. So you see, this is the table RM underscore user in this schema, where which will have information about all the users which you have created for your DRM application. So as you can see, I have these many users. So at the rate, process, standard, and system are being created by DRM itself, and these users cannot be used to log into the console. Okay, this admin user is the user which is created once we create a new application. This user will be created, and rest others AAAMAU I have only created. So this will see why I have created all this. Okay. These are different securities which are available to different users. For example, interactive user, governance user. So I have created the username with the initials of the description. So, but basically, once you create a new plan, DRM application, you will have admin as a user, which will have the admin access, and these three users at the rate process, at the rate standard and system, which is created by DRM to handle different processes. I again repeat, these three users cannot be used to log into the user console. This is your DRM users, which is used to handle different backend processes, but we'll be using this admin user ID to log into our application. Okay, so we'll see once in the subsequent sessions all the tables and all what all tables at the backend are created, so that we get a feel if we do some changes in the UI, so we can go ahead and check in the database table what changes it has made. And this is the web client through which you can log into DRM. This is the URL for that, http://your server name, in my case it's localhost, and then DRM web client logon.aspx. Otherwise, you can log in this from your folder called Oracle EPM system, DRM, and then you can go to your web client from here as well. Okay. So as you see over here, we have got two different applications which are created in DRM. So in the drop-down, you'll see these two applications, DRM1 and DRM2. If you stop any of this application, so you'll not be able to log into that application. Over here, you can see your Windows event log for what all processes or threads which are being used, process IDs and all. Okay. So you see, it's taking time. It will not be able to log in because the DRM2 see the connection time dot while waiting for the server to respond. So you see, there is a green icon over here, which means that the application is up and running. In DRM2, you see it is grayed out. That means you cannot be able to log into DRM2 application. So I'm logging to DRM1. Okay, so this is the look and feel of your web client. These are different options at the left hand side which you see, which are available in DRM. Okay, this is the version pane where you can see all the different versions which you might have created. This at the bottom you see we have hierarchies options where you can see your hierarchies. We'll see in the subsequent sessions what orphan means in DRM and how do we find the nodes and all. So we'll briefly talk about different options at the left hand side so that we get a feel of what all operations can be performed in DRM. Before we proceed with that, I have created one sample version for all of us to have a look and feel how things look in DRM. For example, we just saw in the Excel sheet, we have this time period dimension export from SBase with different properties. So we have parent, we have child, alias, consolidation, data storage, and different generation level time balance and different properties. So I have created this time period dimension in DRM. So this is my version, time period. This is my hierarchy over here, time period hierarchy. And if I double click over here, it will launch the time period hierarchy. So this is my time period hierarchy. So you have year total, bit balance. So if I quickly do a filter over here. So you see top node will always be time periods. And under time period, you see we have bit balance and year total. So, but big balance is coming at the top and then year total. But in our application, big balance is coming at the bottom. We'll see the reason in subsequent sessions why it is coming at the bottom. For now, you understand all the leaf level members come at the bottom. All your parent level come at the top. That's why big balance is coming at the bottom. Then we have year total. We have different quarters, quarter one, quarter two, quarter three, quarter four. And then if I go to quarter one, you have Feb, Jan, March. Again, it should be Jan, Feb, March. There is a reason behind this, because DRM arranges the nodes or members in alphabetical order. So that's why F is coming, ideally F is coming first, then Jan, and then March. Then in quarter two, we have quarter two months, April, June, May, and similarly for different quarters. And you see we have different properties which you can set over here. Name, description, leaf and limb, we'll talk in subsequent sessions. So as of now, we have only system defined categories and stats, which basically gives the statistics, which I will see all these options in our later classes. But for now, you see only system defined categories where you have member name and your description, which is blank, and whether it is a leaf or limb. We'll see this in our later session. But for our specific downstream systems, if we need some other properties, that also can be created in DRM. For example, we have in Excel sheet, we have this consolidation operator, which is a property used in SBase and planning. You have data storage. So these two properties, as you see, is not available over here. So these two properties can be created by us. It's a custom defined property and which can be set for all these nodes. Or any other property, time balance, skip property, formulas, description, any other property which you might need, that can also be created in DRM. So this is how things looks, the hierarchy looks in DRM. Now we'll talk about different options which are available at the left hand side. First option is worklist. This is to implement DRG in your DRM application. Then we have browse. This is the central place from where you can look into all the versions for which you have the access. You could have different hierarchies and you can see any of them if you have proper access to see them. Okay. Then you have query option. This is basically used to query your metadata based on your requirement. So you can create your new query and you can query on an existing version which you might have created. Compare option is basically used to do a comparison between two different versions. For example, if I just give you an example on this one, for example, you have location as a version, okay? And you have right now, EMEA and under EMEA, you have these two locations. And under APJ, you have these two locations, okay? And in the, this is your current system. And in future, you get, for next month, you get a request to add a new location in EMEA region. And you get a new request to add, add two new locations in APJ, okay? So you can do a comparison between this version and this version in DRM. And this will give you what all changes you have made from the previous version. So this will give you what all nodes you have added in location or what all nodes you have deleted in the location in the current version. For example, we delete this L1 in this one. So this also can be extracted from DRM, what all changes from previous version has been made to the new version for all the versions which you have created in DRM. So for that, we use this compare option. The script option basically used to do any changes to the existing version. Okay. For example, as I just said, we have this L1, L2, L3, L4 present. And now we have a request to delete L1 and add L5 in EMEA region. And we have two new locations which has to be added in APJ. So this addition or deletion or updation of properties and all, for example, we have one member which has got store data. And then you come up with a request to change the storage property or the consolidation property. So changes of properties, addition of nodes, deletion of nodes, and all the different operations can be performed through ActionScript in an automated way. For example, if I show you the simple ActionScript which I have prepared to import this time period metadata into DRM is this one. We'll see these. So we have this add command. We have different commands for ActionScript. For adding a node, we have add command. For changing the property, we have change prop command. For deleting, we have delete or remove options available in DRM. So I'm adding this in time period version, in time period hierarchy. Add this particular member, big balance, to this parent time period. And it's a leaf level member, that's by one. And this generates the your ActionScript. So this ActionScript can be copied into a text file, which is created over here, I believe. Yeah, this is copied and pasted in a text file. And this text file can be used through the console of script and then used can be used to do your operations in an automated way. I have used a separator of hash sign. So this is how you load all the changes which has to be done. So in this, I am just requesting to add different nodes into time period version. If I click on run, it will give me error message because these nodes are already present in the system. As we saw, we have time period version which is already created. So this is how we do your changes to your existing versions through ActionScript. Import is basically used to import your metadata first time into DRM. Or else in subsequent phases also, you can import all your metadata into DRM through this import command. So for example, what happens is, for example, you have sometimes you might get a request, for example, we have customer dimension and we have already placed all the customer hierarchies in DRM. Okay. Now there's a request that we get a new customer file next month. Okay, and this has got all the changes intact in this file. All the new customers which are added, all the existing customer which has been deleted. So every time you have to perform import statement because every month you are getting the complete customer dimension file to be loaded into DRM. If it is incremental, that can be done through ActionScript. This also can be done through ActionScript as well to import all the metadata of a particular dimension into DRM. But import is basically used to import all your metadata into DRM. Blend option is basically used to blend two different versions. For example, you have this existing version in place where you have customer C1, C2, C3. And next month, you don't get the complete hierarchy of customers. Instead, you get only the changes which has to be there for this customer. You get only C4 and C5. That's it, which the nodes which has to be added in this month. So what you do, you load this new file which is coming from customer team, which is having C4 and C5 into DRM, and then you blend this customer version with this one, so that this C4 and C5 also starts coming over here. So for this, we use this blender option to blend two different versions. And we can have different criteria to blend and all. So all these have got different options within themselves to work on. Then we have export. Export is basically used to export your hierarchies from DRM to any of the downstream systems. So as I just said that DRM has different types of exports. We have hierarchy, XML generation, compare, difference, EPMA, and then we can export your properties. You can export your transaction logs as well. And this export can be pushed to a flat file or to relational schema as well. So let me show you the options which are available in this export. So you see in the target, you have different options available: client file, database file, and server file. So client file is nothing but your export will be generated in your local machine from wherever you are running this export. If you do a database table, export will be pushed to your database schema which you have created. Okay, and that data model can be used by your downstream systems. Then we have server file. This server file will push your export to the DRM server itself, where you have installed your DRM server. You have to give connections and all that we'll see in the later session. So these three options are available in DRM for exports: client file, database table, and server file. Then we have audit trail as well. We can see what all changes were done to the system in previous month or by which user and all. That also can be checked by audit trail. So we can keep a close track of all the changes which has been done to the system. And then we have this option called administer, which is basically used to create all the properties, validations, and different we can set different system preferences. We can create users. We can give access to different hierarchies, different objects which we create. So we'll briefly talk about these options. So this option is basically available to only administrator or data manager, not to any other user, because this is the basic model which we'll be using for all our hierarchies or nodes which we create in the browse section, which we saw for time periods. So domains we'll see later. This is used for a specific purpose. For example, we start from property categories. So what we do is, for example, we have different properties for SPSS application, right? We have alias, consolidation, data storage, and all. So what we can do is we can collate all these set of properties which are relevant for one downstream system into a group and name a group of property called SPSS, for example. And all the properties which are used for SPSS can be put under this SPSS. Okay, we can have a list of properties for planning. All the properties which are relevant for planning can be put under this HFM or any downstream systems. Or else what we can do is, suppose we are using only SPSS as our downstream system and we have different applications or databases in SPSS. For example, SPSS 1, 2, 3, 4, whatever. Okay. So we can create the set of properties for each cube as well and collate them into a group. So we can create a group called ESS1, and all the properties which are relevant for this application can be seen in this group. So this is only to categorize different set of properties into one section, one folder. Property definitions, this is basically used to create your own properties. DRM by itself gives some core properties, and then we can create our own custom defined properties for our downstream system or whatever is required. Any questions? Okay. Then we have hierarchy groups. This we just saw in the Excel sheet. For example, we have this. For example, we are building metadata for GE. And we have different accounts: balance sheet, income statement, asset and liabilities. These are all accounts, right? But we can create a hierarchy group called account group, and then we can place all these hierarchies over here. Otherwise, we can do this as well. We can, instead of creating a group, we can directly place these hierarchies under GE. This also is an option. But what we can do is we can create a group and place all the relevant hierarchies into one group. So this is also for just look and feel, nothing else. Then we have validations. This, as I said, we have different validations which is required for any application. For example, Sbase has certain validations. For example, level 0 member in Sbase cannot be dynamic calc if it does not have any formula. So this validation can be set in DRM as well. If you create a level 0 member in DRM and you give a storage property as dynamic calc, so it will, and you don't have a formula, then it will give you a warning message that this member requires a formula because it's a level 0 and dynamic calc. So all these kinds of validations, whatever is required, can be created in this validation section. Okay. Then we have node types. Node types are basically used to group a set of properties for a particular dimension. For example, we have this time balance, skip property, variance reporting, and two pass. These things are basically used for account dimensions, not for customers or any other dimension. So, but when you create a property, you will create all these properties. Your alias, consolidation, data storage, time balance, skip property, variance reporting, two pass, all these properties will be created. But when a user logs in and checks for time period version, he should not be going and seeing this time balance, skip property, variance reporting, and two pass, because these properties are not relevant to time period dimension. That's why what we do is, for time period version, we group only these five properties: parent, alias, parent child, alias, consolidation, and data storage. So when a user logs in and checks for time period version, he'll be able to see only these properties: consolidation, alias, and data storage, not these properties. But when a user logs in and checks for account dimension, he'll be able to see consolidation, data storage, and these properties as well. So for this, we have different node types which can be created. Then glyphs, again, is basically used for only user interface. We can, for example, we have different dimensions which we are building. Okay, we have account dimension. Then we have, for example, customers. We have product dimension. So we can give a different icon or a different icon for each different dimensions. For example, if I quickly go to browse. So you see different, this icon, tree icon is next to time period. You have this icon in next to big balance. So this is for a level 0 member. This is for a parent member. So this is the default icon which is present in DRM. But you can change this for your need. For example, you need a different icon for account, parent or account children. You can create them by using glyph. For customers, you want a different icon. You don't want to show the default icons over here. So that also can be done through glyph, just for a better look and feel. Then we have system preferences. We have different DRM system preferences which are there, and that can be changed as per our need. So we have shared members concept, we have password enforcement, how many days the password should expire, what should be the length and all. So all these different system preferences are present. We can change them as per our need. Then we have external connection. So for example, we want to push our DRM metadata into a particular folder in the server. So those things can be done through your external connections. Then we have workflow models. We can create your workflow task and models. Then at the bottom, you see we have different security options. We can create users from here. We can give access. We can give node access groups are basically used to give access for a particular user to a particular version or to a particular node. For example, a user wants only has to be given access only to the customer hierarchy, not to any other hierarchy. Those things can be handled through your node access groups. Then you have object access group. Object in DRM means your different objects which you create over here. Your export, your blend, your compare. These are different objects which are there in DRM. So for example, you create export for customer and you want a particular user to be given, and you have exports for customers, accounts, time period, all other dimensions. But you want a particular user to have access only to customer export. So that can be given through your object access group. So this is basically used to give access to manage your different objects for particular users. And node access group is basically used to give access to different nodes or hierarchies present in your browse section. So this is a brief about all the different options which are available in DRM. So we are we have 3 more minutes as per our schedule. So this is what I had to show for today's demo. Any questions so far?
Can you please tell me about glyphs?
Glyphs is basically used, as I showed you in the browse section, your hierarchies and nodes are having an icon over here. This one, tree icon for time periods, and you have this icon for big balance. If you want to customize your application, like all your account dimensions should have a different icon, those things can be created through your glyph. You want a flower icon for time periods, that can be done through your glyphs.
Okay. Tayo, what about the alternate hierarchies through DRM? Can we manage them too?
Come again, please.
What about the alternate hierarchies? You talk about the hierarchies for dimension.
Yeah, we can maintain that. For example, you have a parent called P1, okay, and you have child C1, C2, and C3. And again, you have in a space we have. You are asking about the shared member concept, right?
Yes, in alternate hierarchies we use shared.
Yes, yes, that can be managed in DRM. We'll see that. For example, we have another hierarchy called P2. And under that we have got C3, so we can manage them. But again, you see, in that's the difference between SBase or plan SBase and your DRM. SBase is a multi-dimensional.
Yeah, but it's common for EPM and for all application HFM planning or SBase.
Yes,
we use all
yes. Exactly. We can create them in DRM as well. We can create them. So this option, this is possible in DRM as well. We can have this C3 present under a different parent.
Okay, and one more question. So this DRM is a metadata source for downstream as well as upstream, for dimensions, like for account, we have a general ledger from where our account dimensions come. So can this DRM feed to Oracle EBS a metadata source?
Yes, it can.
Okay, but then, like for accounts, there will be different properties for the same, let's say for the same GL account, there will be different properties based on different application. Like for SBase, it's property. So you can define based on application that this account is going.
Exactly. All the properties which you need for your custom application that can be created through your properties section, which we saw in the administer. So it's up to us what all properties we need. We can create properties using formulas and all. Everything can be done.
Okay. Thanks.
Welcome. Any other questions?
What are the different downstream systems that are supported in order to use this DRM? Is there any specific?
No.
Only SBase.
No. We can feed this to any of the downstream system. So, but basically, see, we have this EPMA option available, so we can integrate DRM with your EPMA systems. Or else, as I just said, we can export your metadata from DRM to any relational schema, whatever you might have created, and that schema can feed to any your downstream system. For example, I give device as database table, and you create a table at the backend with your column structures and all, and you push your metadata from DRM to your tables. And those tables can be used by your downstream system, whether SBase or planning or HFM or any other downstream, or OBI for that matter. Or else we can give it in a file system as well. If they require it in a file system, we can generate a file system as well. And those files can be sent to different downstream systems for them to use.
Is it possible to show a couple of hierarchies, how exactly it looks for the business users? Is it possible?
Yeah, we have created one time period version over here. This is how the hierarchy will look like for an end user. So that's why I showed initially. You see over here, we have this time period over here. This is the extract from SBase. Okay, we have parent, child, alias, consolidation, data storage, and different properties. So you see, we have time period, year total, and bank balance. But over here, bank balance is coming at the top, and then year total. But in DRM, it's coming after year total. We'll see why there's a reason behind this. Then under year total, we could have different quarters, Q1, Q4. And then under each quarter, we'll have different months. So for example, Feb, Jan, March. So this is arranged incorrectly. It should be Jan, Feb, March. We'll see there's a reason behind this, because DRM arranges the nodes or members in alphabetical order. That's why you are seeing Feb, Jan, and March. Okay. And here you see different properties, which are system-defined properties. Okay, you have name, you can give your description or the alias, whatever you call over here, and leaf and limb we'll see later. And then, as you see, we have only two options over here, category as system and stats, which gives you the statistics. But you can create your own different set of properties and group them. So as I just mentioned you over here, we can group, for example, we have two different SBase applications, SBase 1 and 2, and we require a different set of properties for SBase 1. So what we can do is we can create a property category called property category called ESS1, and all set of properties for ESS1 will be seen under this category. So over here in category, you are, as of now, you are seeing only system and stats, but otherwise you will see ESS1 and you will see all different set of properties for ESS1. So this is how we categorize different set of properties into one. So this is how the look and feel of hierarchies will be there in DRM.
Okay, thank you.
Welcome. Any other questions?
Hi Tayyip, can you let us know how is this course going to work in terms of how often are we going to meet, what are we going to get out of this course, are we going to get any study material or anything like that?
For that, you will have to contact Kapil Sharma.
Okay. All right, thank you.
But for duration, it will take around 30 hours of session. It depends on, see, if we want to cover each and every option, whatever is there in DRM, it could take more time. But if I try to give most of the options which are normally used in DRM, it would take 30 hours or so.
Okay, so are we going to have the sessions every day?
Yes,
this is Manohar.
Okay, Manohar. So we'll start from Tuesday onwards. And we will have a 1 hour session every day, except Sunday. And the training duration is 30 hours. So we will try to finish the course in 1 month only. Sometimes we may have some extended class. So we will try to finish the course in 1 month. And definitely you will be getting a study material for hands on.
Okay. And for each session, are we going to get this? Session recorded or
no session recordings you will get only for missing classes. Let's say if you are not able to attend a session on some particular day, you can inform us well in advance and we'll share the missing class recorded session.
Okay, all right, yeah, thank you, Kapil.
Yeah, welcome.
How about the practical?
See, for practical, my suggestion would be to have DRM installed on your local machine, or if you have access in office, you can work on that well and good. Otherwise, install DRM on your local machine, and it's better, see, for any tool, not only for DRM, whether for OBI or Hyperion or Informatica, for any tool, it's better to go and play around with the tool, then only you'll get to know the options. So my suggestion would be to, once we start our classes, so on a particular day, for example, I am showing you the compare option. Then it will be better if you go and directly log into the tool after the class and do your R&D on the compare.
Correct. Okay. And what is the previous skill set that is required in order to have a good hands-on experience for this DRM?
So it's better to have a bit of relational schema knowledge, relational database knowledge, but not mandatory. And it's better to have a knowledge a bit on the Hyperion side, if you understand concept of hierarchies, family, parent and child relationships, and different properties, then it will be easy for me. Otherwise, it's not mandatory as well.
Okay. What is the normal time for the class?
Come again, please.
The timing for the class.
Timing again would be, I think, 8 a.m.
to 9 a.m. IST. And if you are residing in EST time zone, so I think it would be 9:30 to 10:30 p.m. EST.
Okay, perfect. Thank you.
So you don't worry. You will get complete details just after this session. You will get complete details.
I just joined this class. Can you send the recorded for this class?
Sure.
I didn't hear the entire class. I just. This is Ashrit. Ash. We spoke a few days ago.
Okay, Ashrit. Okay.
Yes.
Okay.
So would you be giving any